The combined full face and double hand transplant procedure was divided into three critical portions. In adjacent operating rooms, surgical teams worked to procure the donor face and hand allografts, while reciprocal teams worked simultaneously to remove the damaged corresponding hand and facial soft tissues from the recipient. The final phase involved the inset of the donor face and hands to the recipient for full restoration. The donor facial incision extended along the lateral neck and posteriorly to include both ears. Soft tissue dissection proceeded to identify the major blood vessels and nerves. The scalp and soft tissues of the forehead were reflected forward, and dissection proceeded down to the periosteal layer. After preservation of the functional structures of the eyelids, the supraorbital and infraorbital nerves, patient-specific cutting guides were also used to guide precise nasofrontal, maxillary, and zygomatic osteotomies. These bony subunits were included in the allograft to maintain ligamentous and muscular attachments in their proper anatomical positions, which ultimately provides for optimal facial function and aesthetics while preventing facial droop. The mental nerves were carefully identified, divided, and included within the allograft to preserve sensation to the lower lip and chin. A genial cutting guide was then placed and geniotomy was performed. Concurrently, the recipient underwent surgery to excise injured and scar tissues and recreate defects for precise adaptation of the donor face. A hairline incision was used, with subsequent removal of external scar tissue along the neck, ears, eyelids, and face, and the dissection of essential structures. The donor and recipient external carotid arteries were anastomosed end-to-end, and the donor internal jugular vein was anastomosed end-to-side with that of the recipient to restore perfusion and drainage of the allograft. Rigid fixation was performed at the chin using low-profile plates, and the cut ends of the mental nerves were coapted. The donor midface and orbital zygomatic bony subunits were affixed to those of the recipient using plates and screws, followed by fixation of the frontal calvarial segments. The soft tissues, including the ears, eyelids, nasal, and oral mucosa of the allograft, were then redraped and tailored to the recipient. Recovery of the donor hands proceeded concurrently with the facial allograft procurement. Soft tissue flaps were raised, taking care to preserve key anatomic structures, which were tagged for identification. The radius and ulna were then exposed. While protecting the neurovascular bundles and soft tissues, prefabricated cutting guides were secured, and the radial and ulnar osteotomies were performed. The donor interosseous distance was adjusted to match that of the recipient. Simultaneously, in the adjacent operating room, skin incisions were made on the recipient's forearms. Soft tissue flaps were raised, and the underlying corresponding nerves, superficial veins, arteries, and vena cavitantes and flexor and extensor muscle tendons were dissected and tagged. Osteosynthesis of the donor and recipient bones was performed using rigid skeletal fixation plates. Microsurgical anastomosis of the donor and recipient arteries, deep veins, and superficial veins were performed, restoring perfusion and drainage. Microscopic coaptation of the median, ulnar, and radial nerves was completed. The muscle tendons were then repaired systematically using a pulvertaff weave, taking great care to balance the tension between flexor and extensor components for optimal hand function. The skin flaps were then redraped and tailored to achieve appropriate soft tissue coverage without excessive tension. This marked the completion of the combined full face and double hand transplant for restoration following severe burn injury.